Now, let us simulate the control circuit of fuel oil supply pump number one and fuel oil supply pump number two. So, this is a continuation of the previous video. So, you must watch the series of this video, especially if you are learning electrical, marine electrical or electrical system for ships. So here, I already explained from my previous video how the control circuit is being created. So now it's time to have a simulation of this control circuit. So I will without further ado, let's get started. So I will switch on CB1, which is the main circuit breaker, and switch on CB2 or fuel oil supply pump number one, and switch on CB3 or circuit breaker number three for fuel oil supply pump number two. So now, as you can see, when I switch on the breakers, the source pilot light is illuminated. So both FO supply pump 1 and 2, as well as the stop indicator for both pump. So meaning your control circuit is power up. So there is already power. So now I will start by automatic the fuel oil supply pump number one. So this is a changeover switch. So I only put fuse here just to connect to the panel board. But this is equivalent for this circuit. Connection is the same, but I only installed fuse as a changeover switch just to connect the variable into the panel board. So I will switch on this one in automatic number one. So we'll see what happened. So I forgot to release the emergency stop. So this is emergency stop. I put the fuse as emergency switch. So this is the only component that there is a variable that can be connected into the panel board. So anyway, the wire connection is still same. So as you can see, the fuel oil supply pump number one is running. So there is an indication of running in the control circuit. So this pilot light is illuminated, and your motor is running, as you can see. So here the timer after 6 milliseconds, which I set into 6 milliseconds, the circuit is being energized, and the changeover switch from open circuit change over into the close contact. So there is a flow of current now to the contactor, as you can see. And your circuit is being energized or working. So now I will proceed to simulate to the fuel oil supply pump number 2. So I will switch on the, I will release the emergency stop switch. So I connected this one into emergency stop switch. So as you can see here, in the pilot lamp run indication and the trip run indication, the relay contact is normally open. And here also, change over switch is positioned now in the close, normally close. So I will switch on the automatic. So as you can see, when I switch on the automatic, the circuit is completed. Oh, sorry. So I resumed the simulation. So there was an error a while ago. So as you can see, when I switch here, I forgot to release the emergency switch. So now your fuel oil pump number 2 is not yet running. So both of them are number 1 and number 2 fuel oil supply pump. The automatic switch is switched on. So the, for the purpose of safety, there is a system on the ship that in case the other pump loss of pressure or the other pump experience a failure, the other pump will start automatically. So now I will simulate, let's say number 1, a fuel oil supply pump is in service but losing its pressure, or the pressure is, the fuel oil pressure is dropping into low pressure. So I will simulate the pressure switch. So this pressure switch is a normally closed contact pressure switch. So I will simulate, I will remove the pressure on this pump, fuel oil pump number 1, and we will see what will happen in the fuel oil pump number 2, since they are both switched into automatic. So we will see what will happen in this control circuit for fuel oil supply pump number 1 and fuel oil supply pump number 2. So I will remove the pressure here in the fuel oil supply pump number 1. So we will see what will happen. So as you can see, the fuel oil supply pump number 1 is still running, but here the backup or the standby fuel oil pump, fuel oil supply pump number 2 is running. So meaning, since this pump lost its pressure to supply fuel to the engine, and then the fuel oil pump automatically, fuel oil supply pump number 2 automatically start to compensate the pressure, the in order to have a normal pressure to supply the fuel to the engine. So So you can just manually stop this pump number one since this is still running. So press the stop button. So as you can see, you will the indication of the fuel oil supply pump number one is stuck. So you can see here, and your pump is already stuck. So your fuel oil pump, fuel oil supply pump number two is running. And this still, so there was an error again, so I resume the simulation. So as you can see, your fuel oil supply pump number two automatically started. I forgot this breaker, so automatically started, and then this is the purpose of safety, because if there is a standby pump, once the pump in service, which is EPO supply pump number one, has dropping its fuel oil pressure, then your engine, your main engine, and generator engine on ships will, or your power generation system with it, which is your generator engine, will black out or will stop immediately. So by the use of the standby pump, the standby pump will automatically start and continue to supply fuel to the engine to continue operation. So now I will put the system into normal again. So I will energize again, since this pressure switch number one is normally close contact. So I will put into normal condition. So as you can see, when I put the pressure switch into normal condition, the fuel oil supply pump number one automatically took over the service, the operation. So the fuel oil supply pump number one start immediately, and the fuel oil supply pump number two stop also immediately, because of the supply of power, the main supply of power is taken from the fuel oil supply pump number one. So this is the system of the fuel oil supply and booster unit of my previous ship. So my, I think my PC need to be started. So I never need to be restarted. So I never switch off this program since yesterday. So I think my PC is becoming low memory. But anyway, we will continue the simulation. So now I will simulate also the fuel oil supply pump number two. So I will switch off the, or I will remove the fuel oil pressure in the pressure switch number two of fuel oil supply pump number two. So as you can see, the fuel oil supply pump number one is not stopping. This is continue running because of the power supply is taken from the fuel, or the main power supply is taken from the fuel oil supply pump number one. So this is the system in my previous ship, fuel oil supply system, electrical system. So I will remove again. I will put again the pressure, or I will energize again the pressure switch number 2, since this is normally close contact pressure switch. So as you can see, the circuit is ready and waiting for another command to start. So if I remove the pressure to the number 1, so number 2 will automatically started. When I put again the pressure into number 1, or I put back into normal position of the pressure switch, then number 2 will start and number 1 will start to take over the operation, the continuous operation of the pump. So that is the simulation for the automatic simulation of the control circuit for EPO supply pump number 1 and EPO supply pump number 2. Now I will simulate also the manual operation. If the engineers or the engineer watch or the chief engineer decide to put the fuel oil supply pump in manual operation, so I will switch off both automatic. Or correct procedure, we will start to manual. So we will not we don't need block out. So we will start first with the manual. So I will start the number 1 into manual. So as you can see, number 2 is running, so I will start number 1 into manual. So I just so as you can see, the circuit is closed here, as you can see. So I will start the number 1 into manual. So just long press the start button. So as you can see, number 1 pump is running to supply fuel to the engine. So I will switch off the automatic of the number 2 fuel supply pump. So as you can see, your pump is stuck. Then I will start the fuel oil supply pump number 2 in manual. Long press the start button. So now your fuel oil pump number 2 is running, and also number 1 is running. So it is up to the engineers to decide which pump to be in service. So normally our practice on board the ship, in every month we will change over from pump number 1 to pump number 2. So when the logbook, when we change the logbook, engine room logbook, so this we made this habit, this system, when we change the logbook in the first day of the month, we will change also the pump, the auxiliary. So this is for the proper rotation of the usage of the auxiliaries of the machineries, so that the running hours will be also equalized for the purpose of the overhauling. So we maximize and utilize each auxiliary. So now, if you decide to stop the number one, then press stop, and your number one pump is going to be stopped. Now it's already stopped, as you can see. And if you decide the number one pump in service, so just click start button. And then start the number two pump. So your number two pump is stopped now. So that's it. So those are the operations of the control circuit of fuel oil supply pump number one and fuel oil supply pump number two. Now let us take a look the fuel oil booster pump number one and fuel oil booster pump number two. So we will simulate this control circuit. So it is the same with the fuel oil supply pump number one and fuel oil supply pump number two. But I have to explain also this circuit because the fuel oil supply pump and fuel oil booster pump are working together to supply fuel to the main engine and to the auxiliary engine or the generator engine. So the fuel oil supply pump is taking suction from your fuel oil service tank and delivers to the what we call the deaerator tank or the mixing tank, and from the mixing tank your fuel oil booster pump taking suction and deliver to the injection pump to circulate to the injection pump and vice versa. So the other term of fuel oil booster pump is fuel oil circulating pump. So that is those are the pump to supply fuel to the main engine, to the ship main engine and auxiliary engine or generator engine. So now I will switch on the breaker for fuel oil booster pump number one and fuel oil booster pump number two. And then I release the emergency stop of fuel oil booster pump 1 and 2. So you have already the current flowing in this circuit, as you can see. The control circuit. So I will switch on in automatic the number 1 and 2. So the same operation with the fuel oil supply pump, same operation, but they are working together, the fuel oil supply pump and fuel oil booster pump. So now your fuel oil booster pump number one is running, as you can see. So I want to simulate the standby system. In case of low pressure, low fuel oil pressure of the fuel oil booster pump number one, so I will remove the pressure here, the pressure switch. Your fuel oil booster pump number two automatically running. And then you can switch off manually your number one fuel oil booster pump. So now your fuel oil booster pump number 2 is running. So this is very important. Even the port state control will check the standby system of the auxiliary machinery on ships, because this is very important. If there is no standby system or backup system, your ship will black out immediately in case of failure of the service pump or of the pump which is in service. So I will energize again the pressure switch. I will put again to normal. And then your number one top over will start immediately. Your number one pump is running. So why this is happen? Because the main supply is taken always from the number one. Number one main supply. So I remove the pressure. So supposedly there is no pressure here in the number two because the pump is not running. But to simulate, I will remove the pressure. So your number one tip booster pump is still running because the main supply is taken from the number one. I will remove. I will switch on again the pressure switch. So the circuit is ready for the operation. Again, I switch on this one. Second shift. So second shift. The circuit is not ready for operation when I remove the pressure in the pressure switch on the EPO booster pump number 2. When I energize this pressure switch, then the circuit is ready for operation. So one more time to simulate the standby system. So I will remove the pressure on the number one. And your number two is running. Then I will put back into normal. So you can switch off. Now it's automatically switch off. But for number two, since the power is taken from here, so you can manually switch off if you want. So now I will simulate the manual operation. So I switch off the automatic, and then I will start the pump number 2 in the manual. Long press the start button. So as you can see, your pump fuel oil booster pump number 2 is running in manual, and I will switch off also the automatic of the fuel oil booster pump number 1. So as you can see, your fuel oil booster pump number 1 is switched off. So I can start now in manual, as you can see. So long press the start button. So both of them are working in manual. So I decide now to stop, because to stop the number 2. Just press the stop button. So your number 2 pump will stop. Or now is only stop. So if I put also the number 2 in service, so I can start in manual. And then I can stop manually the number 1. So that is how the fuel oil booster pump number 1 auto control circuit is working. I hope you learned something in this video. This is a series of tutorial from the start, the creating the diagram until the simulation. So for those who are learning, or I encourage those cadets, students, junior engineers, or even senior officers on board ship in learning electrical, because this is very important, especially nowadays. Most of the ships are ship system are in automation system, so it is far behind if you are not studying electrical. So automation is a combination of a lot of electrical system, electronic system, pneumatic system, hydraulic system, PLC system, a lot of system of the item automation that should be learned. So one fundamental to study, which is very hard for the first time, is the electrical and the electronic. So I encourage those who are taking marine engineering, or who are already marine engineer, who want to learn electrical. So thank you for watching in this video, and please click subscribe and notification bell so that you will be updated if I have a new video. So in this channel, I have a lot of videos for the students, and I have also in this channel Engineer Mathematics. So just explore my YouTube channel, which is RS Nautica, and then you can find videos related to ships system. Thank you for watching, and see you on my next video.